Hi, let's have a look at what we're gonna create today. Step 1, text setup. I will type first line of the song, with text tool. You can see the font name I am using on your screen. I'll increase the size, just a bit. Go to the effects panel and here search for, linear wipe effect, drag and drop this effect onto the text layer. Tweak this like I'm doing. It's very simple. Now select both keyframes and hit F9 to easy ease them. Let's increase the feather amount. Cool. Select both keyframes and go to the graph editor. Here make a wave like this. Let's open scale and add some keyframes. Increase the value. Now it should have some nice zoom out animation. Perfect. Let's enable 3D layer option. If you can't see this 3D button, just right click here and choose switches, so we can play more with the text. Click it to enable. Now we have more rotation options. I will add keyframes for X and Y rotation. Position as well. Let's change these values to something else. It will give our text a cool rotating motion. Increase the position value until you push it out of the canvas. It's not necessary to replicate the same. You can do whatever you think could fit the idea of your video. With 3D option enabled, you get to play with more options. More options means more possibilities. Let's quickly preview it. Let's tweak this a bit more, to get smooth and organic motion. In the graph editor, make sure here your speed graph is selected. I'll make some nice curves with these waves. This looks good. Let's go with this. For now, type the other line of the song. Open scale, and add a keyframe. Set the value like so. Go forward and change the value to something else. Trim this layer as well. Now apply some rotation and position keyframes, like I'm doing. Add position keyframes and move it out of the canvas as well. By the way, when you're creating a lyrics video, it's good to have idea and theme in your mind. Like in my mind, I am going for a cinematic look. So I'm applying respected animation to the text, unlike ultimately complex or fancy animation. I want it just smooth. As you can see, it will come in and go out like this. Don't worry, you don't have to create layers one by one. After this step, you can simply duplicate the layers. It will save your time. Set the curve. All right, it's good. I hope you're following along. Now add more keyframes to move it out. Set the curve. If you have any question in your mind, don't hesitate to ask. Let's quickly preview it. Now duplicate the first text layer. I will disable the 3D option on this duplicate layer and put it above all. Move it forward. Double-click it and start typing the next line of the song. Apply the same movement like we did for the previous text layers. Now at this part, I want zoom in animation with this text layer. So add scale keyframes like I'm doing. I want something like this. Zooming text effect. So I am trying to achieve this look. I will increase the scale value. I am asking once again, let me know if you have any confusion. Select these keyframes and make a curve like this. When making animations, always try to get into the graph editor. It gives your animation a nice and smooth motion, and it looks attractive to the eyes of the viewer. Yes, that's good. Let's quickly preview it. Good. Add keyframes to the opacity to make it fade. Adjust the keyframes. Easy, ease them. Go to the graph editor and play with the curve. So, it will zoom in and quickly fade out, like this. Now I will add all the text layers with different movements with the same method as I demonstrated in front of you. I hope you're following along. Now, at this hey part, I want something special. Like in the video you can see. Something like jumping effect. So let's add scale keyframes to this layer. Make a curve like this. It will come instantly and go out in the same manner. Go forward and set scale value to 0. Make a curve like this. Let's quickly preview it. Good. If you want, you can add rotation as well, like this. Now it's looking like this. Everything is smooth, right? Don't worry, it's an easy tutorial. If you find it hard, you can message me on my social media. I always try to help. Okay, trim the text layer respectively. Let's have a look what we ended up with. Beautiful song and a beautiful voice. Okay, I will select all the text layers, right click and pre-compose them. Let's name them as text 1. Now from here, I will duplicate this text 1 comp. Now we have text to comp. Double-click it. Here I will delete these four layers, as we don't need these lines in text to comp. I'll delete the last layer as well for this song. Now drag these blue things like I am doing. Right-click and choose Trim Comp to Work Area. Okay, now you can drag this text to comp onto the timeline and place it to the respected lines. Alright, let's move to the next part. Step 2, Moving Lines. First, let's hide the text layers by clicking on these eyes. Grab Pen Tool, make sure your fill color is set to none. And your stroke has some value. Start drawing random line. Open this drop down. Here select Trim Paths. Open it, set keyframes like I am doing. Move forward. Alright. We have this cool moving line. Don't forget to trim the layer. Now I will just duplicate the layer, and in this duplicate I will change the line shape to something else. Cool. In the effects panel, search for roughen edges. Drop this effect on the line layer. It will give them a liquid look. Tweak the settings, you're free to make full use of it, and you can achieve different looks. Simply copy this effect and paste to the other line layer. I hope you get the idea. Let's quickly preview it. Now I will create many lines as I want in a furious manner. Okay, now select all the line layers. Right-click and recompose them. Step 3, Clips and Overlays. Here I have some clips I downloaded from Paxels.com. It is a great site for free to use videos. As you can see, I can barely read the text, so I will search for drop shadow effect and apply it to both text layers. This video has no movements except for the water, so let's add some scale and position keyframes, and give it some movement. As you can notice, the color of the video is not so great, we will fix it. Adding motion to this clip will give a cool zoom out effect, as if it was shot with a drone moving upwards. Now our clip has some motion, and it looks good. Try to sync the zoom effect with the text like I am doing. You don't need to exactly replicate what I am doing, you're free to put your own ideas. In my videos, I just demonstrate you the ways, so your job is to catch the ideas and create something unique with your own creativity. And I'd love to see your work with these ideas. Let's adjust this curve, so we will have a nice zoom effect. Don't forget to trim the layer. Okay, after this clip I will add another clip. I will apply scale keyframes to this clip. I am going to show you how to make a cool transition in a few moments. By the way, if you wanna hire me for a lyrics video or short animated ads, you can send me a message and we can discuss about your ideas. Let's adjust this curve. Adjust it in the center. Perfect. I will simply add more video clips and adjust them according to my liking. Let's create the transition I mentioned earlier. Right-click and create new adjustment layer. Put this adjustment layer above both video clips, go to the cuts between both video layers, then press these buttons to move, go 10 frames backward and forward. Trim the layer. Now search for offset in the effects panel. drag it on adjustment layer. Create a keyframe for shift center 2. Move it back. Now add minus sign in 640, your values may be different, just add minus sign. Now you can notice this movement, I wanna make it look smooth and cool. Easy ease both keyframes and make a curve like this. Cool. Now apply directional blur effect to the layer. Tweak it like so. Change the angle to 90 degrees. Move forward and set the value to 0 again. Let's have a look at the effect. Looking cool already. As you can notice the black lines around the corners, I want to remove these lines, so I will search for optics compensation effect in the effects panel. And drag it on the layer. Tweak it like I'm doing. Now we are done with this, it's time to add some cinematic overlays to the video. Here I have some overlays in my computer. I will select some of them, and drag them into After Effects. Now from here drag any of those to the timeline. And set the blend mode to screen. Looks good. I don't like the color of the video clip. So I will search for an effect called Apply Colorlet. Drag it on the video layer. It'll open this window and from here I will select any cube file available in my computer. Cool. Our video now have a cool looking color. Okay, now we're done. I will keep adding overlays to the video and keep setting blend mode to screen. I hope you enjoyed the video and learned something new. If yes, then consider subscribing. It means a lot. If you have any confusion, just message me on my social media. I will try to help you for sure. Okay, then I'll see you guys in the next video. Stay home, stay safe. Goodbye.